Welcome to the U.S. Croquet Association Seniors Masters National Championships. It's U.S. Rules Croquet held at the National Croquet Center in West Palm Beach, Florida, November 2018. John Osborne is the tournament director. This is singles block play and championship flight between Danny Huneycutt at -4 and Dick Brackett at a handicap of -1. We joined the game about 15 minutes in. You can see red up there by hoop two, and red's clip is on hoop two. Both blue and black are on hoop three, and yellow, which took off from red to get to where it is now, is for hoop four, which for the stripe balls is that hoop right behind Dick Brackett. We're on the veranda of the NCC clubhouse, about 40 feet off the south boundary for the strike ball. And you'll hear encouragement emanating from the crowd.
This is hoop four, right there. Right. Danny's both on hoop three. I'm just trying to get the state of the game. Looks like his are both on three. And that's Dick's red ball.
Red is 2 or 3 yards southeast of one back, and black is now in great position for him to turn this into a three ball break after he makes hoop five. Or not.
Sunday night. Well, they do it in Lauderdale. And so did we. It was lovely. Susan.
Had black hit red, he probably would have done a croquet out to blue in corner two and gone to his hoop three. Yellow just sets up, wisely avoiding getting partner dead. I wonder if he considered just dropping it off by hoop one as a remote pioneer for red to hoop two and then getting a three ball break going that way.
Chris is going to have to give it a rush to do it. Oh, man, look at that. And look at the rush he gave. He used the tangent line on that one. That's better than stuffing it.
You're in the way. Move over to play.
Why don't you just leave it there and come back to the park? Out in the middle. Oh, that's why. Because if it had been on a battery, he wouldn't have gone to get it. Now he can send red. Yeah, he'll just do a croquet out and go to five.
Not really a croquet out. All he has to do is send a ball to his partner Blue on the boundary.
He could do it. He could do either way, right? Because he loves this play. You know, he's just setting a break for Blue.
Yellow goes to corner three. He probably wanted red a little closer, both to make it easier to shoot at and to put it on the boundary in case yellow shot at it.
It might be in one.
I'm only, you might, well, I might have gotten you at the medical. I'm only in one because I got Sharif to do that.
They're double banking with Mike Todorovich and Randy Cardo playing the solid ball.
Take care. Great to see you both. Thank you. So with black opponent then, because it's opponent dead, he can't really do something impregnable. That's how he's going to do it. He's not going to go to bed.
Checking for the wire of red on black so we can decide whether he has to move it after he makes four back.
You got the jump.
So in exchange for black's getting opponent dead to set the break up, he gets six hoops with blue and leaves black right in front of his hoop, ready to get clean. And yellow got the one back clearance.
See, where's red? Red's way the hell up there, so he takes the line. It's the hot ball, it doesn't do anything that's good.
Like to play, Danny.
You may have noticed that I'm moving away from that transparent deadness board because sometimes it's hard to see. And I can't move it around. When I do it like that, I can put it anywhere I want to. Like right over Danny's head. Red failed too. I missed a couple of rotations and somehow blue and black got up north. Blue got in front of Pinault. And as you can see, yellow's going back to the south boundary. Blue makes Pinault to get clean and joins back up with black on the east boundary. A little north of hoop three. With the ball so far apart, a lesser player would have been content to wait a rotation, give black a good rush to hoop five, and then hope that yellow makes a mistake. Danny didn't get to minus four by waiting for the opponent to make mistakes.
We get to do Evan Costello on Sunday.
Oh, yeah. I was going to ask Sarah for marching instructions.
Yes, I had my best selection 8 to 9 and 4, and I should have been 11 and 3. I'm starting to begin to believe that I know
what you're doing.
Not quite like that guy does. Yeah.
Are you having a good
time? Yeah, I'm 4-1. So I am. No, I'm still. I'm a true.
You're not playing nothing right now.
Exactly. And I just got to get to playing it.
Thank God.
This is right.
I played a 9. It wasn't good for him. It wasn't good for me.
I got a lot of. Being 26-3, but I mean, you know, I mean, that said, right. Now that said, at our level, you should be a stand. If you get sloppy, because you know he's not going to attack, so you set up, which you would never do again.
You play it there. Yeah. Are you going to do it?
Yes.
Good.
I think black is first ball and last turn. This defensive Roquet out that's coming up is featured in Bob and Ted's tactics DVD. He puts red down by blue so that yellow can't join up with it. And then red goes out on a boundary so that yellow has a long shot perpendicular to a ball on the boundary.
I can talk, it's okay. I cut all the talk out anyway. Okay. But there's so many people signing up for this tournament, that's all they can do.
Three and a half. And it should be one.
But I gotta earn it. Yeah, they're in there. It's okay.
And then over two and a half, it's playing nines. I mean, is there?
It's just, this is the way. Last year, it wasn't. My goal. Red can win this game if he gets one peel on yellow on his way to pegging out from hoop two. But of course he has to hit this double target on the boundary first. But it's a little bit wide, and Danny Huneycutt takes the game over Dick Brackett 17-5. Hope you enjoyed the video. Give us a like if you're so inclined, to make a comment about the analysis, and subscribe so you get notified when new videos get posted. Danny was undefeated in block play and went on to win the tournament, to no one's surprise.